Oh, that's it. I don't know what word to use. Hello, everybody. Welcome back to a brand new video. Today, I'm going to be reacting to the new Bury Tomorrow song, Life Paradise Denied. If you saw my last video on these guys, or if you keep up with the band in general, you most likely know that their previous rhythm guitarist and clean vocalist is no longer in the band, and they've gotten a new clean vocalist who does synth stuff in addition to the vocals. And it was somewhat scary to have like a new song with a new clean vocalist, because the chemistry between the members previously was just out of this world, and to lose that is scary. But then they came out with the song Death Ever Colder, and it was incredible in my opinion. I really, really enjoy that song. It's one of my favorites of the year, I think. And it actually is a song that, like, when I come back to it, the ending of it genuinely makes me emotional every time, or most of the time at least. And it'll be interesting to see, can they keep it up? I hope the answer is yes. The last song was so good that I think they'll crush it. Before we get into the song, if you're not subscribed to the channel, make sure to click that subscribe button and click that join button as well. It really, really helps me out. Thank you. And also make sure to check out The State of the Scene, the best alternative music podcast out there. You can go check them out by clicking the link in the description down below. Seriously, go do it. This is Life Paradise Denied by Bury Tomorrow. Let's go.
I've been hearing whispers that would chill you till the bone, forced into the darkness.
Okay.
But I now call my home the only light I ever had. Was it meant to
say,
burn now, walking back to fire with the scars that I have
earned. Okay. That's a fun riff. Oh. That's not the riff that I expected from that, to be honest, but I'm glad. Cause this is fun. This has like a really bouncy, fun feel to it. Also very like surprising just intro. Like even the vocals, even the way that they felt was it felt new and strange. Which is like very necessary for like this brand new era. Yeah, okay. Ooh. Hell yeah.
This is life and misery's time. Looking for the end.
Oh, that's a fucking
time. Life and misery's time.
Oh, that's it. I don't know what word to use.
Misery's time. Looking for the answers. Regulatory life. I've been waiting on the echoes to answer.
Oh no, stop. No, stop. I'm not ready. Dudes, you gotta hold on. Hold the fuck on. I actually gotta hear the heavy shit again. Like, don't if you hear that and you're not sitting like this, you're a fucking psychopath. That's a fucking ripper right there. Oh, this is fucking, this is just a straight vibe. And it just sounded like the chorus is gonna really explode and be great as well and really work well with this.
I've been waiting on the echoes to answer me.
Ooh.
Staring at the dark to face these voices that keep screaming.
Yeah.
No reality. Until you return to me.
Oh, straight back. Oh. Yeah, do that fucking, get that Slipknot feel in there. What the fuck, dude? And plus, like, a bunch of other like, I don't even know what this is reminding me of, but it's fucking awesome. Oh. I love the energy in the video, too. Everyone is just,
oh.
I'm so excited about it, and I love it.
Ooh.
Like, everyone's everyone's fucking spinning and kicking and flipping.
I love this.
Okay. Oh man, this is like a fun song. Probably not really, but like just the feel of it. It's just so much fun to listen to. That's such a nice continuation to the chorus. The why don't you answer me part. I love that. Oh, okay. This is reminding me of something very specific. I'm not even sure. Some of the vocal stuff reminds me of like some like Bullet for My Valentine type shit. I don't know if I said that in the last video. I don't remember. This bridge here reminds me of something. Like the feel of it. Yeah, I don't know. I just got chills. No. That chat is so cool. Fuck me. Okay. So there's no question about whether they can keep it up from that last song. That's for sure. Oh my god. I thought that last song went hard. Like, this just, like, took that energy. And I mean, they're very different songs. Kind of two sides, I guess. Which is cool. It feels like two different sides of this new era. Listening to the song itself, without even going into the lyrics, it's like, this is fucking fun. And heavy and aggressive, and it's just like everyone's energy is just amped up to a million. These two songs are very different, but they still very much feel like different sides of the new era, like I said. I liked how they had like that more clean bridge with the Bullet for Valentine sounding stuff at times. It's just the vocals. And I don't even know. I might be insane because I might just be remembering that wrong. I don't know. But I like how they had that part and then like they went into that heavy, nasty shit because I thought that bridge was going to be like a breakdown, and then they didn't do that, but then they brought in like just a great bridge, a great like clean bridge instead, that then led into, you know, just like this heavy shit. This song I feel does such a great job of knowing exactly what it's bringing to you and then just like doing that and then knowing when to leave. Like, this song is so good at like, here's a fucking fun riff, here's blah blah blah, and then it just, like, every idea is placed so well. Like, I don't know. I felt like this song is really structured in a nice way. To where every part that comes up is sort of, like, exactly what I wanted at that point in time. Even if I didn't really know it. So it's like, but after I heard it, I'm like, oh my god, yes. I can't. This is just so much fucking fun. Guys, you did it again. You absolutely did it again. With this one. That makes me so excited for like a full length, for example, because I'm just like, yes, I know they can do it. And I know they can make something that's incredible. Also, one thing I gotta say is that I love how every part of these last two songs, every single second is like a hook. It's something that I just kind of realized. Even the verses are like as catchy as anything else in the songs. And that's something that's really hard to do. And that is something that I think Buried Tomorrow has been really good at in general. But it's just like hearing this song and actually now, for me specifically going through the lyrics here, and then just listening to the sound of it and figuring like how the vocals go, how they're sort of structured, and then thinking back to Death, it literally, everything is so damn catchy, which I think is why it sticks as well as it does, because just the entire song is like hooky as fuck, you know? I'm just really impressed, I think, with just Bury Tomorrow's ability to just like never writing anything bad, you know? They can't do it. So it's safe to say that I'm very excited about the new era at this point, even more than I was after hearing the last song. I also want to ask the question for any Bury Tomorrow fans who was skeptical, maybe didn't even like the last song. What do you think about this one? Just hearing more of it is probably gonna change some minds, and also with how fun this song is, maybe this one is what it takes for some fans who are still not really along for the ride yet. I think having the mindset of the new vocalist, Tom, is not trying to be Jason. Though, as I think I pointed out in my last video, there were like moments where I'm like, okay, he's sort of sliding in on like certain things that I feel like Jason used to do, or just like the tone, but he's not trying to just do what he did. You know, there's no like, it doesn't sound like he's trying to necessarily fill his shoes. He's buying new shoes. And I think if you think about it like that, that can, I don't know, maybe that can change your mind on it, or at least change your perspective and maybe make you want to give them another chance if you're not on board. I very much am at this point, and I was after hearing that first one, so yeah. Anyway, let me know what you guys think of this song in the comments down below, and how excited you are for new Bury Tomorrow stuff. And also, thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, make sure to leave a like, and also subscribe to the channel if you are new. Also, click the join button to become a member. It really, really helps me out. Thank you. Follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and join my Discord server. All the links will be in the description down below, in addition to everything from the state of the scene. Also, let me know what other bands and artists you want me to talk about, review, react to, and I will see you guys later.